Numericals of electric field intensity. Now see this numerical. Find net or resultant electric field intensity at C due to these two charges Q1 and Q2 of values plus 10 microcoulomb and minus 10 microcoulomb, and this is equilateral triangle of side 10 centimeter each. Now change centimeter into meters, micro into simple numeric value 10 to the power minus 6 coulomb. If it is minus, put minus. Now our question is, we are finding electric field intensity at C. So we want to find net or resultant intensity at C. Remember, as in Coulomb's law numericals, it is a vector quantity. So you will have to write in vector notation, electric field at C, finally, or net or resultant is equal to electric field at C due to Q1 plus electric field at C due to Q2. As per parallelogram law, it is like resultant vector, it is like A vector, it is like B vector. Now from parallelogram law, you know, you will have to find magnitudes of A vector and B vector, like magnitude of EC1 vector and EC2 vector. So if you want to find magnitude of EC1 and magnitude of EC2, then here we begin with concept number 1, magnitude of electric field intensity at any point P. We want to find electric field intensity at P because of this charge, may be positive, may be negative. Now remember, it is not Coulomb's law. In Coulomb's law, we find force. Force between two charges. Here, only one charge is given and another is a point. It is a point at a distance R away from Q. So, this R. R is the distance between charge. Maybe positive, maybe negative. And this point. This is point of consideration where we want to find electric field intensity. It is not Q2 as per Coulomb's law. It is point, only one charge. We are finding electric field intensity at any point due to this charge, maybe positive, maybe negative. Breathe in. Now formula is magnitude of electric field intensity at P is K. This K is same, Coulomb's constant. That is 9 × 10⁻⁹ Newton meter square per Coulomb square. That is also called 1/4 πε₀. Now K, mod of plus minus Q. If it is plus, write plus. If it is minus, write minus. You are finding magnitude. That minus sign will be absorbed. Still you must write minus sign while finding magnitude. Divided by distance between charge and point square. That is R square. Focus on this. We are applying this formula in this numerical. C, electric field intensity at C due to Q1. Focus on C, focus on Q1 and distance between them. It is L. So you will write it like this. K mod of Q1 divided by distance between this charge and point. L square. Similarly, electric field intensity at C due to Q2. K mod of Q2 divided by distance between charge and the point C. It is L square. Now see one simplification. This K, 9 × 10⁻⁹, Coulomb's constant, mod of Q2. See, Q2 is minus. You should write with minus sign, minus 10 microcoulomb upon distance square. This is 10⁻⁻⁹ meter whole square. Now since you are putting all the values in SI, so put it like this, minus 10 into 10⁻⁶ mod. Now you can simplify and units will be Newton per Coulomb. You know, electric field intensity formula, F is Q into E. When you know F is Q into E, then E will be F by Q and units of electric field will be force per unit charge, Newton per Coulomb. See this. So you will write units as Newton per coulomb. You can solve it, EC1, EC2. Since data is taken like this, they will be having same magnitudes. Breathe in. This is part one. How to find magnitude of electric field intensity at any point P. Now part two. Direction. Direction of electric field intensity at any point. See two parts. For plus Q charge, what is the direction? And for minus Q charge, what is the direction at any point P? First of all, remember, it is radial. Radial means direction of electric field can lie only along the line joining. Line joining charge and point. So for finding direction, step number A, you should join the line between charge and point. Like this is the charge and this is the point. So first of all, join them through a line. Join charge and points along a line. Direction of electric field can lie only and only along the line joining. That is called radial. Point number two or B. You consider yourself standing at P. That is called start from P. Here we will say point number two. For positive charge, electric field direction is radially outwards. You know, radial means along the line joining. Outward means away from positive charge. See the C point. Start from P. Move away from positive charge. See, you have two options while starting from P and you are able to move only along the line joining. Either you will be moving towards positive charge or away. So when it is positive charge, away from positive charge. This is radially outward. Direction of electric field at point P. And for negative charge, it is radially inwards. Inwards means towards negative charge. So it is called or. Move towards negative charge. See, if it is positive, direction is away from positive charge. Like one bulb, point bulb illuminating light in all the directions. Likewise, electric field is radially outward from positive charge. And for negative charge, it is towards negative charge. This is the direction at P. See, at any point, direction is inward like this. This is for negative charge. This is inward direction of electric field. At any point, I'm not saying left, I'm not saying right. I'm saying you have two options. While starting from P, P is the point of consideration where you want to find direction of electric field. For positive, away from positive. For negative, towards negative. This is called radially outward. And this is called radially inwards. Breathe in. Now we apply this concept in the numerical we are solving. This is EC1 vector, EC2 vector. See, point number one or A, join the line between charge and point. We are finding direction of EC1 vector, electric field at C due to one or due to charge placed at A. It is positive charge or negative. First of all, join the line between charge and point. Second, start from point. Now here point is C. If it is positive, move away from positive charge. It is EC1. If it is negative, so towards negative charge. That is called radially outward or inward. Breathe in again. For positive charge, first of all, join the line, then start from point. If it is positive, away from positive. Now, EC2 vector, it is negative charge, so it is radially inwards. So, join the line between charge and the point. Start from point. If it is positive, away from positive. Now it is negative, so towards negative. This is the direction of electric field intensity at C because of negative second charge. Now breathe in. This is direction concept applied in the numerical. Next. Now you know the directions. You may write here EC1 vector is radially outwards and EC2 vector radially inwards. Now you see, as per parallelogram law, this is point C and two vectors, A vector and B vector, joined from tail to tail, which is in this case EC1 vector and EC2 vector. So when they are joined from tail to tail, this is called theta, angle between EC1 vector and EC2 vector. It is equilateral triangle. So 60 each, this total is 180. So 180 minus 60, this theta will be 120. So theta is the angle between EC1 vector and EC2 vector when they are joined from head to head or tail to tail. In this case, it is 120 degrees. Breathe in again. Now, magnitude of resultant. Resultant is EC net. Magnitude of resultant is called under the root a square plus b square plus 2ab cos theta. In place of a it is EC1, in place of b it is EC2. So you will say it like this: mod of EC1 square, EC2 square plus 2 EC1, EC2 cos theta. Now you may solve it. Answer must be written with units Newton per Coulomb. Next is direction. Direction of net electric field at C. So as per parallelogram law, this resultant vector lies somewhere in between A vector and B vector. So this EC net will lie somewhere in between EC1 and EC2. As well as, you know, these magnitudes are equal. Magnitudes of EC1 and EC2, when they are equal, then it lies exactly at the half, midpoint. What? Meaning is, this resultant will lie somewhere in between. When magnitude of EC1, EC2 are equal, it lies at midpoint. Midpoint means half of 120. This will be 60 degrees. So you will write it like this: EC net vector lies at an angle of 60 degrees with respect to EC1 vector or EC2 vector. Breathe in. Similarly, you can do so many numericals. See this. Now both charges are positive. This Q1 is positive and Q2 is positive. Now find net electric field intensity at C. You can do it yourself, but see, for positive charge it is radially outward, EC1 vector, along the line joining away from Q1. For another positive charge, along the line joining away from Q2. This is called radially outward from Q2 as well as from Q1. Again, this is given equilateral triangle. So theta between them will be 60 degrees. And you know, magnitude of EC1 and EC2, they are equal. K mod of Q upon L square, both they are equal. So as per parallelogram law, you know, magnitude of net electric field will be under the root EC1 square plus EC2 square plus 2 EC1 EC2 cos 60. This case theta is 60 between EC1 and EC2. Got it? Then resultant will lie again at midpoint because again EC1 EC2 having same magnitude. So this angle is alpha, or you can write it is at 30 degrees. This is homework. You can do it yourself. Same numerical. Now see the next. two charges plus q minus q separated by a certain distance are given to you. Now part 1, find electric field at midpoint. Now see, this is midpoint. And question number 2 I will tell later on, part 2 of the same. First of all, find electric field at midpoint. Now how will you find? See, electric field at midpoint is electric field at midpoint due to charge 1 plus charge 2. Again, it is vector equation. You will have to follow IJK technique or parallelogram law technique. Then find magnitudes. Electric field at M because of 1. At M because of 1. You know, it is midpoint. It will be R by 2. So electric field at M because of Q1. K mod of Q upon distance between charge and point. Remember, it is electric field. We are focusing the distance between charge and point. It is R by 2 square. Similarly, electric field magnitude at M because of Q2. It is K mod of Q2, which is minus Q. Again, the distance between charge and point. So you will write it R by 2 whole square. You know, this minus sign will be absorbed in magnitude. Then direction. For plus, it is radially outward. Focus it separately. It is plus Q, it is M. For positive charge, it is outward, away from positive charge. So electric field vector at M because of 1 right side. This is the direction. EM1. Now again focus separately for Q2 charge. Otherwise you may have some mistake, some error. This is Q2 minus Q. Breathe in. For minus, it is radially inward. Focus. This is the point. From point towards negative charge. This is the direction of electric field at M because of 2. For plus, away from positive. For minus, towards negative. Starting from point. Either you move away from positive charge, or starting from point you move towards negative charge. Again, it is on the RHS. You will see both vectors are coming in same direction. When vectors are in same direction, then you may follow IJK or parallelogram law technique. As per parallelogram law technique, resultant intensity or net intensity at M will be magnitude of EMN vector plus magnitude of EM2 vector. Because when two vectors are in same direction, their magnitudes are added up. You can solve it by putting the values and direction. This EM vector also in the same direction along EM1 or EM2. Focus, when they are in same direction, direction resultant is also in the same direction. EM net. You may solve it by IJK technique. It is left to right I gap, left to right I gap. Then you solve it, I gap, it will remain I gap. Now the part 2 of the same problem. Find, after asking this part 1, continuation point is find force on 5 microcoulomb when placed at M. You know, electrostatic Lorentz force. This 5 microcoulomb is test charge, Q0. When this Q0 placed at M, focus, at M, meaning at electric field, net electric field at M, or in net electric field at M. See, when you are placing charge at M, Q0 placed at M, then it means Q0 placed at a particular electric field intensity, EM net. It implies force experienced by this Q0 will be Q naught into electric field intensity, net electric field intensity at m. So put in the values of electric field, net electric field at m, then you are able to find force at q naught when placed at m, force on q naught when placed at m. Got it? This can be done from Coulomb's law also, but in this numerical he is asking part 1 of the question, find electric field at midpoint, net electric field at midpoint. Then after finding that, if q naught placed at that point, what will be the force? So you'll have to follow this way. Breathe in. Now see, if the question is like this, it's a square three charges, square of side L, let us say this is A, B, C, D, find resultant or net electric field intensity at D because of these charges. How will you find? See, this is reference axis Y and X, this is point D. Now for Q1, it is plus, see the direction first. For positive, it is radially outward. E vector at D due to 1. Again, second is plus, join the line between charge and point. If it is positive, away from positive, it is E vector at D because of second. Now see, it is negative. Because of this, we are finding electric field at D. So for minor, it is radially inwards. Electric field at D because of minus Q, because of 3. See, our question is, we are finding net electric field at D. So electric field at D will be because of 1, electric field at D due to second, plus electric field at D due to third. As per concept, you should find magnitude, part 1, ED1 vector's magnitude, it is K mod of Q by L square, then magnitude of electric field at D because of 2, K mod of plus Q by distance between this charge 2 and the D, it is diagonal root 2L. And similarly, electric field at D because of 3. Electric field at D because of 3, K mod of minus Q upon L square. You know, minus sign will be absorbed. It will be written like this. This is point 1, magnitude. Second is direction, as shown in the diagram. See, for plus electric, for Q1, electric field at D radially outward. For plus Q second, Q2, again it is radially outward. For Q3 minus, it is towards minus, radially inwards. Then this numerical can be solved either by parallelogram law IJK. When it is, you know, more than two vectors given to you, then you should follow IJK technique. You should input the values in vector notation. See point number 3, ED1 vector. Focus on this ED1 vector. It is left to right. So left to right means positive x direction, ED1 into I cap. This ED1 is magnitude of ED1 vector. Then ED3 vector will be written as magnitude, you know, this is magnitude ED3, KQ by L square, and it is downward, negative I direction, minus J cap, it is minus of ED3 J cap. And see ED2, it is somewhere in between at an angle 45. So resolve it into two components, Aju, Baju. This is 1, ED2 cos 45, and this is ED2 sin 45. So this ED3 vector will be ED1 vector plus ED2 vector plus ED3. Then what to do? Put in the values of this ED1 vector, ED2 vector and ED3. ED2 vector is not written. See, I'm writing it here. ED2 vector, it is left to right, ED2 cos 45 I cap, left to right, it is upward, plus ED2 sin 45 J cap, this is ED2, should be put in this expression. Likewise, ED1 here, ED3 here. Now, this is final answer. Still, you can find magnitude direction as taught in vector numericals and Coulomb's law numericals. Got it?